Hi there, welcome to another video of Just Being Earnest. In today's video, I'm going to share with you how does Keppel DC REIT make money. If you've always wanted to invest in a data center REIT like Keppel DC REIT, which is the first and only pure data center REIT on the SGX stock market, then be sure to continue watching this video as I share with you more about data center and its business model. Before I start, hope you can give a like for this video and also subscribe to my channel. Let's look at the background history of Keppel DC REIT. It went IPO in December 2014 with only 8 properties on its portfolio. Fast forward to today, it expanded aggressively to now have 18 properties across 8 countries. They are located in Australia, Germany, Ireland, Italy, Malaysia, Singapore, Netherlands and United Kingdom. And their most recent property acquisition was this year when they acquired the remaining 999-year leasehold land interest at Keppel DC Dublin 1 and Castlebar's Data Centre in March and May 2020 respectively. So what is data center, you may ask? It's a building with critical facilities that houses servers and network equipment that supports clients' critical IT business operation. And you may ask, can't this be done at the actual office of the company instead of being at a data center? Well, it's possible, but if you consider the amount of cost to set up and the critical role it plays, it's best to let the experts manage it and also have it set up in a suitable environment. There are 3 types of leases for the data center that Keppel DC REIT offers. The first is co-location. Co-location means that the equipment, space, and bandwidth are available for rental to retail customers. The customers pay for the rental of the equipment and uses its own servers. Co-location facilities provides a diverse client profile and lease expiry. The second is fully fitted lease. Fully fitted lease means Keppel DC REIT has equipped the building, but the tenants has to manage the facilities themselves and also pay for the maintenance expenses. The last lease type is shell and core. Keppel DC REIT simply basically provide the tenants with the building. The tenants just have to use its own servers, manage the facilities themselves, and cover all other expenses. Fully fitted and shell and core facilities provides income stability with typical longer lease terms. Let's look at what's inside a data center that Google runs.
A data center is the brains of the internet, the engine of the internet.
It is a giant building with a lot of power, a lot of cooling, and a lot of computers.
It's row upon row upon row of machines, all working together to provide the services that make Google function.
For companies that might need data centers are industries that require a lot of data, such as financial institutions, telecoms, internet companies, etc. They can be internet companies like Google, Facebook, Shopee, Lazada, financial institutions such as DBS, OCBC or UOB, and telecoms like Singtel, StarHub, and M1. Now for the growth story. Will we see a demand for more data centers in the future that will see Keppel DC REIT growing? Definitely. With more countries and companies going into digitalization, the increase in internet usage will mean more data, and more data means more data centers are needed. With SG's government already encouraging and incentivizing the F&B industry to adopt cashless payments, what's more for all the other industry as well? And it's not that easy to set up a data center compared to other property types like office or retail. There are certain regulatory and compliance requirements that one must meet before it can become a data center. Having the necessary backup support system, high-tech security, and 24/7 uptime, data centers have to be built and managed very stringently. Overall, I feel that Keppel DC REIT is in a very interesting industry of its own. With more companies and countries going into digital, there will definitely be a need for more data centers, and that's where Keppel DC REIT will benefit from this uptrend. Thank you for watching the video. Hope you learned something new today. Do give a like and subscribe to my channel. Also, do check out the links in the description for our blog. I'll be creating videos about personal finance, lifestyle, company reviews, investment, and side hustles. You can also let me know what you want to watch, and who knows, I may do a video about it. Have a great day ahead, and bye-bye.